So the first thing to do is to open your software, Blender software, or just double click. So you will see this user interface. So we're going to change this interface so that you can use it for our video editing purpose. So the first thing, so you can remove this one by click on the anywhere in the 3D view window. Okay. So the next thing you need to do to change all this panel. Just click on this part, move up, see the arrow there, here, and release your mouse button. Same as here, just do this. And the next one is the left, see this? Okay. So now we only have one window actually. So the second thing is to have some layout for our user interface. Something like this. Okay. So for this one, we just open the properties window. Okay. So for this one, we open the video sequence editor and we click on the view, image preview, window, centrally open the properties. Okay. So the next thing is this one, the button one change to video sequence editor. So this is where you can put your video clip on different channel. And the last one is the timeline. So for the video, you're going to open the properties. So now you see nothing of course because you don't have any video here. Okay, so this is a layout. So the second thing you need to do is to go to the user preference to change some settings. Go to input, check this one, emulate three button mouse. Okay. And after that go to system, go all the way to the bottom. And because this is a video editing, we're going to use it for a video editing purpose, so we try to maximize the memory that you can use from our PC. So in my case, I have 8 GB RAM in my laptop, so I use 4 GB RAM for this video editing purpose. When we try to render the video, we're going to take a lot of the memory resources. Okay. So the next thing you have to do is just set user setting and cross the window. There are a few more things you need to do. So first, you go to the properties window, you see the display, image editor. So this one you check keep UI. Okay. And after that, we go to the playback to check the audio strapping, ABCD, and frame dropping. So I'm not going to explain why I did everything. The idea is to make you start easily. So if you want to know more, you can follow this link in the description and the detailed tutorial to explain one by one about some principle in the video editing and why we change all this setting. Okay, so now we are almost done. So the next thing is set this file. Okay, so set. Okay, define a folder where you want to keep a file. Okay, so here we just put a new so now your file is set. So the next thing is to put our video. In this case, we have two video. So we have a video that capture the lectures, and also a video to capture the PowerPoint slide. So I have another video to show you how to make this PowerPoint slide into a video. And for this, you can capture by using any video software. Video can be